Kalo narajan jagatam param gurum tilokonatha natapad pankajam prayenamarta bhagavantam achyutam jakshante pasanna vibhinna chetasa.
Gaudiya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Jagadguru Bhattacharya. We will have to get rid of attraction and repulsion of this material world. Gaudiya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Jagadguru Bhattacharya. We will have to get rid of attraction and repulsion of this material world. Those bonded souls, naturally they are feeling some attraction or repulsion. So actually, if they are not out of attraction and repulsion, they cannot actually start Hari Bhajan, not possible. Gaudiya Goshtipati Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that if there is discrimination between Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan, then he is bound to fall down. If there is any discrimination between Supreme Lord and his devotees, then there is no question of any bhajan. Surely he is going to accept amangal. Papa speaking this way. He is going to accept amangal. No way out, actually. So, actually, you can remember the sloka I started with. Here in this Bhagavad sloka, it is written, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, prayena deva ma. Prayena, usually it is seen that there is a human being here in this material world. They don't like to do actual Hari Bhajan. They don't like to do Hari Bhajan, though that Supreme Lord is worshipped by all Brahma, Sankar, everybody. Trilokanatha natapad pankajam. His lotus feet is worshipped by everybody. Infinity world, the Siva, Sankar, Brahma, everybody means not common soul, bonded soul, cannot do. Those are demigods also, those who are not fully bonded. They are also praying dandavat to him, at least, knowing the glory, knowing his glories. So actually this is Kali Kal, their luck is very bad luck. They cannot hear good advice, they cannot do Hari Bhajan, they don't like to do Hari Bhajan. If at all they are going to get any opportunity to do Hari Bhajan, still they cannot do Hari Bhajan. That is the bad luck. They cannot do. And actually, I told you yesterday that Saraswati Thakur speaking that actually for bonded soul we will have to preach with a very humble mood, trinadapi. If there is no trinadapi, then we should not go for preaching. With this trinadapi humble bhava and getting full kripa of Guru Varga, you will have to go here and there for preaching. And what I told before, Brahmaji requesting to Naradji Maharaj, "Ho Narad, I am giving you this Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. But you will have to preach this Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan in such a way, Jatha haro ninam bhagavati, yatha haro ninam bhagavati, jatha haro bhagavati ninam bhaktir bhavishvati." You will have to preach in with such a mood, such a humble attitude, so that you can do something concrete for this bonded world. With false ego you cannot do. You should not have any self-interest, because you should remember you are the servant of Supreme Lord. You are not going to demand any salary. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Das kori beton mori deho prem dhan. We are your asulka dasika. You can remember in Gopi Gita. Nakhalu bhavan. Gopika. Nandano. You are not actually the son of Gopika. Nakhalu Gopika Nandano Bhavan Akhila Dehinam Antaratmadrik. Actually, Akhila Dehinam Antaratmadrik. You are a super soul sitting in everybody. So, O Prabhu, Akhila Dehinam, in everywhere you are sitting. So, as per the inspiration of Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan, we will have to carry out the mission of preaching of Chaitanya Vani, accurate Chaitanya Vani. We have no scope to express any false ego. There is no scope. Yesterday I was discussing. We will have to run here and there by the order of Guru Bhargo. We will have to run here and there with a basket of absolute truth holding on head. And while we are going here and there, somebody can insult us, somebody can honor us, and this kind of situation should not contaminate our heart. This should not contaminate our heart, because we have no expectation from anybody. We are asul kodasika, we are free servant of Supreme Lord. We are totally free servant of Supreme Lord. We have no expectation. So this Chaitanya mission, we'll have to carry out this Chaitanya mission all together. And we'll have to preach Chaitanya Vani very accurately everywhere. And those who are going to reject Prabhupada openly, those who are going to reject Prabhupada not directly, those who are going to reject Prabhupada directly, those who are not going to reject Prabhupada directly but indirectly, those who are going to reject Prabhupada directly and those who are going to reject Prabhupada indirectly, both groups, they are, you know, they will have to suffer for that deplorable situation they are going to meet in their life. So anyway, we have to follow the instruction given by Prabhupada. Prabhupada giving instruction that you should not forget that a sannyasi means you should not forget that sannyasi means sannyasi is always three danda are there. So three danda means you will have to give punishment to your body, speech and mind. This way you will have to remember always that you are going to give punishment, you are going to take a strong vow of non-violence, you have no enmity with anybody. I already told we should not develop, we should avoid, you know, attraction and repulsion anyway. So, this kind of mood we should develop. Tridanda means always humble attitude and what bow he should take. I am actually salaryless servant. I don't need any salary. I'm going to serve Supreme Lord without any salary. That mood should be there all the time. Trinad of sunich and sannyas vrato not different. Though externally you can find Trinadavi bhav is applicable for all, even grihastha devotees and everybody can follow Trinadavi, and especially those who are sannyasi, they will have to follow this Trinadavi from heart. Prabhupada speaking, you can remember that Prabhupadananda Saraswati Pad Paramahamsa Acharya expressing the humble mood. What kind of humble mood? I told that day, Dante nidhayo tinakam padayor nipatta cha kaku sat etat aham brimihe sadhavo sakalameva vihayo chaitanya chanda charane kurutanurag. Dante nidhayo tinakam padayor nipatta cha kākuśat etadaham babrami he sādhavo sakalame babihāyo dura chaitanya chanda charane kurutānurāgam chaitanya chanda charane kurutānurāgam. Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Goswami Thakura Prabhupāda speaking. You see the humble mood of Prabhupādānanda Saraswati, the topmost Paramahansa, Tungo Vidya Saraswati, with so humble mood, he is speaking, I am going to catch a straw, grass in my teeth and going to fall down on your lotus feet, please you all, and praying very cravingly from heart, please you try to do bhajan, you try to leave everything, whatever affluences you have, whatever property you have, whatever belongings you have, you should throw and come with niskinchan bhava. You should come with niskinchan bhava unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava to serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You will have to be very careful. All the time you will have to follow this mood. Prabhupada speaking, you see the mood of Prabhupadananda Saraswati Pad, he is also Tirandi. I request all my friends, all my Shiksha Guru Varga, to follow this procedure. Because this procedure is very unique procedure through which you can come out successful. The unique mood of a preacher is that he always thinking that I have done no seva to anybody. I have done no seva, I am failure. Yesterday you can remember I was describing about Ekayan Pantha. And I was also explaining Ekayan Pantha mean any devotee want to do any seva, he should come unto the lotus feet of Sadguru Charan, and all his qualities, all his efforts, all his seva must be channelized through a proper channel to reach up to the lotus feet of Nityananda, to reach up to the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. This mood is called actually Ekayan Pantha. We
Gaudiya Vaishnava strongly believe in Ekayan Pantha. You cannot understand because you are foolish. You can remember while Sri Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami having so much quality, but still praying unto the lotus feet of Vyasadeva Goswami, Vrindavan Dakhakur, please bless me so that I can do some seva. Out of your causeless mercy, something can flourish inside my heart. This is my prayer. At all, any vanity should not touch my heart because I am going to take Uchista from you. This is the mood of Ekayan Paddhati. You should understand. Practically, Ekayan Paddhati can never permit you to speak. The whole world is failure in preaching. Only I am successful. Those who are in Ekayan Paddhati, those who are going to follow this Ekayan Paddhati, those who are going to advise, those who are going to follow Ekayan Paddhati, under the guidance of our Sadguru Vaishnava, they can never speak that way. You all are failure in preaching. Only I am successful. That's mean you are totally failure. It means you are totally failure, 100% in preaching. That's why you have the privilege to speak that way. A trinad vibhav never permit. So you see Prabhupada speaking, who my Shiksha Guru Bhargo, who my friends, I request you all, because I learn in from my Paramahansa Guru, Srila Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, this unique procedure of trinad visanijana taro visheshana amani na manodena kirtaniya sadahari, this four procedure. You should be humbler than the blade of grass, and you should grow the enduring power more than a tree, and you should give honor to everybody. You should not expect any honor from anybody. Amane amade kirtaniya sadahari. With this condition, you will have to do. With this procedure, you have to do. This is the only condition. This is the only condition through which you are eligible. You can get the power to sing the glories of Supreme Lord. If you are not going to adopt these three specific procedures, four specific procedures, for chanting Harinam or singing the glories of Hari Prabhu, you cannot go for preaching. Your preaching is totally failure preaching. Be careful all the time. That's why people are with heavy regret speaking, people are regretting. Those who are going to discriminate between Supreme Lord and His devotees, surely they are going to accept Amangal in their life. No respite. They are going to 100%. They are going to accept Amangal in their life. They cannot come out successful. They can go down and down and down due to Vaishnava Aparat. They cannot come out successful any day. So, Prabhupada requesting, oh my friends, any amount of honor you are getting anywhere, not that in foreign country, here also, any kind of honor you are going to get from any society, any person, any amount of disregard, of insult you are going to get from any group, that should not touch your heart. Because you should remember, those who are giving me honor, their material, their voice, when they are shouting, Jai Ho, Jai Ho, that is also material. If the whole world going to give me Jaikar and giving garland to me, I should fix up my attention unto the lotus feet of Guru Padmo, then I can realize what is their mood. That day I was speaking, you can remember, somebody can speak, me, Sambhava is genius, somebody can speak, You are actually a beast, Januar. All same for me. Because those who are glorifying me, they are also material, their voice is also material. Those who are going to insult me, they are also material, their voice is also material. So material voice, material sound, vibration, not coming from the transcendental world. It is vanished in this ether, taranga. Vanished, we cannot see. But transcendental sound vibration coming from up. If Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami is going to give any honor to me, then I should remember that Gurudev or Param Gurudev going to give me honor and giving some certificate, you know. At that time it was the usual practice, procedure to give honor to honorable person. Those who are doing night seva in Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math, Prabhupada watching everybody from heart, at the time of Gaur Purnim Day, Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava, Prabhupada used to give one title to competent personalities. You are Mahapadeshak, he is Mahapadeshak, he is Upadeshak. This way one title Prabhupada used to give to increase their encouragement. And through this honorable word, our Guru Varga so humble, so humble, so humble, they never think that Prabhupada going to give me this honor, that Maha Mahapadeshak, that doesn't mean I am such a big monkey that I can preach everywhere. On the contrary, they are thinking again, over and again, that to increase humility, to increase humbleness, Prabhupada giving nice treatment to us so that we can come up to the level. Prabhupada speaking me, you are really Maha Mahapadeshak, that means you will have to come up to that level of Maha Mahapadeshak. It is my order. Follow? We should think that way. Otherwise, Prabhupada speaking sometime, I should not have such a bad luck. I should not have such a bad luck from my Guru Varga to hear my personal praise. I should not have that kind of bad luck. I should not have that kind of bad luck as to hear some praise, prasangsa, glories from Guru Varga. That kind of bad luck should not come in my life, that Gurudev speaking, oh, you can speak this way, you are so great. It's my bad luck. If Guru Maharaj going to beat me with his chappal, speaking, you idiot, know nothing, Kesab Goswami is shedding tears all the time and speaking, now, Prabhupada, you gone. Who can come and chide me and speak, you are foolish number one? You are foolish number one. Who can speak? Nobody there to speak that way. I like to hear his sweet chide. I like to hear your voice, Prabhupada, you now gone. This is the humble attitude of our Guru Varga. Parampuja Keshav Goswami speaking, in Harikatha, all my God brothers, Srila Goswami Maharaj, Ban Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pradip Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, they are, you know, starring the whole world to preach actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani. Keshav Goswami is speaking in Harikatha. I am very proud that all my Guru Bhai, all my God brothers, Goswami Maharaj, all Ban Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pradip Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, they are stirring the whole world. Such a gravity of their preaching. They are preaching in front of Rani Elizabeth, everything. Big, big seminar. Maybe they are not preaching in common level, but automatically if big level preaching is done, automatically down by down to low level, automatically preaching can, if nectar is there, drop by drop the nectar can come. You can remember that day, especially I was discussing about preaching procedure. Preaching can be done both way, one is negative way, another is positive way. One kind of preaching is very fast, motivated preaching. Another kind of preaching is very slow, positive preaching with no motivation. To get the total sovereignty over the world, no such motivation. He is saying, I am only instrument, Prabhupada giving instruction. Our instrument is there inside our heart. Guru Varga and Bhagavan can play this instrument. Our instrument can go on playing under the lotus feet of Guru Varga all the time, uninterrupted way, non-stop way. Non-stop way, our preaching can go on. All the Tridanti path, all those who are Tridanti path of this, you know, Gaudiya Mission and Gaudiya Society, they are all living Mridanga. You cannot, you have no right to cut the Siddhanta of Prabhupada. Then you are a fallen soul. You have no right to cut the Siddhanta of Prabhupada. Then you are a fallen soul, 100%. So Prabhupada speaking, those who are actually Tridanti path of this Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math, they are all actually living Mridanga. They are living Mridanga. This Mridanga can play anywhere, any country, any continent. They can go and go on playing this Mridanga. And Brihad Mridanga Seva is also effective. Brihad Mridanga Seva means Vani Seva, because when I am speaking, maybe a few number of people going to hear, but I keep expectation even after my death, thousands of thousands of people can hear this absolute truth. Maybe they are going to put some agitation against me now, because their brain gone out of order, they are in Maya. Someday they can realize really, without any self-interest, Maharaj wanted to rectify us. Maharaj wanted to give this darshan, the siddhanta. If I have any motivation, any kind of duplicity, then I would have taken shelter of duplicity to get honor, prestige and money, everything from you. What a kind of unique sacrifice, you idiot, you cannot understand. What kind of unique sacrifice are Guru Vaishnava going to suffer? But still you are going to chase him, beat him, cut him. This is your character, dirty character. So, Prabhupada speaking, all those sannyasis, those who have total idealism of Gaudiya Mission, they are actually one living Mridanga. They can go anywhere and go on playing. They can itself play their Mridanga. And the message of Gaudiya Mission and the message of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can go intact way, unabated. Intact way can propagate all over the world. Maybe slow procedure. Maybe slow procedure, but be sure. This procedure is concrete procedure, advised by Prabhupada. And Brihad Mridanga Seva is most important. Through Brihad Mridanga Seva, Prabhupada wanted to propagate all the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the form of books and magazines. This way, whole world can get a long-term effect. Prabhupada not gone. We'll have to remember Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote so many things. I should not make any commentary about Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I should not make any commentary on Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Itself a commentary. If I go to make one commentary, then I can make some dirty things. All we should do under the guidance of Guru Bhargava. You can remember, I like to give you a reminder, fresh reminder, that when Ballavacharya wanted to express some false ego, I cannot accept the, you know, commentary of Sridhar Samipad. That's why I was bound to write this way. That time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very angry, like fire. How dare you are going to avoid Sridhar Samipad? Jagat Guru Sridhar Sami, he is Jagat Guru. He is enjoying the full kippa of Nisingadev. Bhagi Sajasya Badane, Lakshmi Rijasya Chabakshasi, you should remember. Apragita Saraswati, Chinmaya Saraswati, Transcendental Saraswati, sitting there in the tongue of Nisingadev. So who is going to pray unto the lotus of Nisingadev? He can glorify Chaitanya Saraswati. Sinuta da Jayadeva Swaraswatim. You can remember Jayadev Goswami that day. I was maybe 6 months ago. Jayadev Goswami also going to depend upon Chinmaya Saraswati, Transcendental Saraswati, his kripa. Who is Transcendental Saraswati? Chinmaya Chaitanya Vani Saraswati. Vani in the form of Vishnupriya Saraswati. So always and every time, we should remember all the time, there is no scope to express any false ego. We have no scope. That's why Prabhupada was speaking, Brihad Mridanga can propagate long term, but I should not distort. If I have actually 100% love and respect for Prabhupada, I should speak and write intact. I should not change even one word. What Prabhupada told, I will have to speak same thing. What Prabhupada write, I will have to follow same. Maybe representation is a little bit different, but the same I will have to do. When Ballavacharya wanted to express some false ego, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so angry, he would say, you are actually pros. How dare you want to violate Sridhar Samipad? He is Jagat Guru, enjoying full kippa of Nisingadev. Sridharam Betti Nisinga Pasadat. By the mercy of Nisingadev, all the secrecy of Bhagavatam manifested into the heart of Sridhar Samipad. You going to violate him, insult him? Go! After that, when Ballavacharya growing humble attitude, then coming and praying for pardon, begging for pardon, then and there Prabhu say, you should not express that kind of mood. It's strictly prohibited. How dare you are speaking that way? He is great. Who all going to write some commentary? Never you can see they are going to violate Sridhar Samipad. They are going to follow Sridhar Samipad. Vishwanath Chakravartibad, Madhvacharya, all, everybody, they are going to follow. They are not going to insult. They are not going to insult Sridhar Samipad. They have no right. So this way, Prabhupada wanted to teach us how you can become an exact pot. Pot means patra, to catch the kippa of Guru Varga, and you can also propagate the teachings. Prabhupada speaking, you should remember the mood of Prabhupadananda Saraswati, you should remember the mood of I, my Guru Pad Padma Paramahansa Sestho, Amar Prabhur Prabhu, Amar Prabhu. Actually, he is going to teach us this way. Prabhupada speaking, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the topmost idealism in the whole universe, in the infinity Brahmanda. The procedure adopted by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you should accept it. You should not violate his instruction. So each and every time, anywhere you can remember, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to Udupi, there also Mahaprabhu asking, I'm interested to know your sadhu sadhan tattva. Would you please speak about sadhu sadhan tattva? Then those Madhvacharya Sampradaya, some devotees started speaking, and Mahaprabhu speaking, you are going to cheat me because you see I am actually Mayavadi sannyasi. Na, you speak me, I am actually Mayavadi sannyasi, so you want to cheat me. You are not going to speak about actual sadhu sadhan tattva. I am sure. This way Mahaprabhu wanted to change the mood of those. Now Mahaprabhu with this humble mood started speaking about sadhu sadhan tattva. They gone mad. This is really sadhu sadhan tattva, this. But we are speaking. Our Guru Bhargava teaching us that like in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, you can find so many sahajiyas are there, they can identify themselves as the follower of Chaitanya, right? So many tilak, mala, everything, they are chanting, everything. They all want to prove that we are the follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Prabhupada going to prove 100% they are not at all the follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They are all sahajiya. Similarly, we learned from Guru Varga that time when Mahaprabhu reached there, by that time the Siddhanta and Vichar of Madhvacharya was little bit distorted. So they speaking that way, but Mahaprabhu with very humble mood wanted to speak, teach. That was one kind of preaching. Mahaprabhu wanted to learn from them, but actually it is one kind of humble mood of preaching. Mahaprabhu wanted to preach them. When Mahaprabhu was successful to inculcate the actual teachings, then they are actually feeling sigh. Oh, really? Sattva Sandhattva is this? Really so? But what to do? We get it from Madhvacharya this, but Madhvacharya not going to, be derailed from Shuddha Bhakti. I can prove someday. Because he in line with Brahma. And Brahma again getting Kamgayatri also from Krishna. So how possible we can expect, how we can expect that Brahma is, and Vasudev is also fallen? We cannot expect. So intact way we can expect. Some representation can be different regarding Rasa Tatra. Because maybe it was up to that point, Madhvacharya was ordered by Supreme Lord, you will have to go preach up to that far. After that, some other, devotees coming, they will have to. So you will have to make the way clean. You have to know, clean. You have to make the way clean, road. Then other preacher coming, they are going to give about fine rasatata like Sanatan, Roop, Jiva Goswami, but that can be the reason. Like, Vrindavan Das Thakur speaking this way, and Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking more and more secrecy, deep philosophy and rasa tattva. Whereas Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami always praying, I am taking the uchishta of Vrindavan Das Thakur, please if there is any aparat, please excuse, should be excused. This way, Vrindavan Das Thakur Maharaj going to stop up to this point, because it is a instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to go up to that point. After that, some other, my parshad coming to express more deep philosophy. This way, we'll have to think. Now the preaching procedure of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you see, so humble. I can refer another example so that you can understand that when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reaching Varanasi, there in front of Mayavadi, what kind of humble attitude Mahaprabhu is going to express. You should remember it, should not forget, whereas Mahaprabhu not going at all in any Mayavadi society. But to do kripa, to bestow kripa, to give kripa on them, Mahaprabhu was bound to accept that invitation by that Brahman. He is going to accept that invitation to reach there to bestow kipa, to give kipa on them, Mayavadi. So, all Mayavadi there, thousands of Mayavadi there, and their leader, Acharya, who? Prakasananda Saraswati. Then when Mahaprabhu reaching their spot, going to wash his lotus feet, there in some dirty place to wash, after that, after washing, he is sitting in the dirty place. Then all sannyasis, they are shouting, why you are sitting in dirty place? You should come here. And in the meantime, when Mahaprabhu washing lotus feet, after sitting, Mahaprabhu expressing some impulsions, power, light, like magnet, magnetic power. Then those sannyasis, they gone mad. They are shouting, why you are sitting in a dirty place? You should come and sit in among us. But Mahaprabhu speaking, I have no right to sit among you because I am fallen sannyasi actually. I have no capacity, I am a hin sannyasi. I have taken, some Bharati Sampradaya. You are actually elevators. How I can sit with you? No. You should not speak that way. Your power, your body color, your humble attitude, your appearance itself speaking that you are Narayan. Your appearance, your glamour, your power, it seems that you are Narayan. That's mean Mahaprabhu is successful. Out of his humble attitude, Mahaprabhu was 100% successful to own their, get victory over their tight heart. Successful. Really so, Mahaprabhu is Narayan, Mool Narayan, original Narayan, Krishna. How is possible for Mayavadi to understand and detect that you are Narayan? How is possible? Whereas they don't believe the eternal feature of Narayan. They are speaking, when you meet with any Mayavadi, I always meet then Namo Narayan. They can pay the number. Namo Narayan. You are Narayan, I am Narayan, everybody Narayan. So there is a market of Narayan. Oh, countless Narayan there. Some foolish people going to accept this kind of Siddhanta, some Mayavadi Sampradaya speaking, that we are going to give the bandara of Doriddo Narayan, poor Narayan. Doriddo Narayan Seva. Some Mayavadi. They are also Mayavadi. But in little bit different way. They are speaking, today is the bandara of all poor Narayan. We are going to give bandara of poor Narayan. Poor Narayan? Narayan is enjoying six full opulences, but they are speaking Doriddo Narayan Seva. Foolish number one. How is possible that Narayan become very poor? Eh? They are speaking this way. And whole world, even the Prime Minister also, going behind them. What to speak? Follow everybody. They cannot understand the jugglery there. They cannot understand the misconception there. It's Mayavadi. Jive Pem Koraje Yon Sei Yon Sevija Ishwar. I was when I was small boy, I was bound to write Precy and Substance on this subject. Master, they, all teachers, I was also bound to do. Now I understand, Hari. Jive Pem Koraje Yon Sei Yon Sevija Ishwar. Those who are going to express love for all jivas, that is the topmost procedure to serve Supreme Lord. That's mean they want to say there is no separate existence of Supreme Lord. Now my question is that if you are at all so merciful, more than Guru Vaishnava, they were going to express this mood, jive pem kare jai jan, those who are going to love those jivas, they are going to serve Supreme Lord. No need of serving Supreme Lord separately. So my question is that, if you have that kind of, mercy, then why you are going to kill a fish, cut a fish? Why you are going to cut with sharp weapon a goat to take fish or meat? How possible? You want to prove that you have so much mercy? Foolish world cannot understand. Whereas common, you know, philosopher in the foreign country, from France, Italy, German, they are also speaking so nicely. So that at least they are approaching right direction, maybe not full direction. But they are, you know, going to give lecture in Chicago and speaking one to be. What lecture? What lecture given by him? You go and show me what lecture, what is the meaning? Only not even ABCD. Not even ABCD of Sanatana Dharma he wanted to speak. And wanted to get clapping in front of whole public. And the publics are so idiot and foolish, they are clapping. It's quite impossible to touch the actual heart of Guru Vaishnava. So you can criticize Guru Vaishnava, it is your privilege. But be sure, you are going to get punishment for infinity period. Supreme Lord can never tolerate. If you are going to make any mistake unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, that can be excused by Supreme Lord someday. Tomasthane aparade tore hari nam. You can remember. Tomasthane aparade tore hari nam. When somebody is going to make aparada unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, his nam, hari nam, can excuse me someday. If there is any aparada unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, I can get excuse. If day by day, if I go on praying to Supreme Lord and go on doing Harinam, someday Supreme Lord can excuse me. But Supreme Lord can never excuse me if I am going to criticize some, you know, devotees, nice devotees. That is impossible for Supreme Lord. So this way we see whole world running towards wrong direction. Whole world running toward wrong. Who can save them? Only Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Dagar Prabhupada. If we are going to show submission, what is the symptom of submission? If you understand that Maharaj speaking something about Prabhupada, Maharaj something speaking about Keshav Goswami Maharaj, something about Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj, what is the evidence? What is the evidence that I am actually in line with Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Maybe I am a cheater. Who can prove it? You can prove. Who can prove it? A pure Vaishnava can prove it. That you are not in line. If you are at all in line, all same Siddhanta and Vichar can come. And same humbleness can flow through your heart. Trinada Vibhav. This is the evidence, only evidence. That you are successful in your bhajan and preaching. Otherwise, whatever philosophy you are going to represent, any amount of philosophy you are going to represent, you are going to get deviated from the track of Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. Sometime, Sarodindu Bandhabadhyay, Sarodindu Rai speaking, Prabhupada, you are so successful within this short period, you are successful to make 50 Gaudiya Math all over this India and abroad. You are going to establish. Prabhupada asked me, what you are speaking? What you are speaking about 50 Gaudiya Maths? I wanted to establish Gaudiya Math into the heart of all Jivatma there in this Brahmanda. You are speaking only 50 Gaudiya Math? Now they are all going to big Pracharak. Okay, they are going for preaching. But they are also going to put some restriction in their preaching, then they cannot speak so clearly. Prabhupada speaking, I can show you. They are speaking all about their absolute truth, not with full-fledged heart, going to reserve something. That time Prabhupada speaking. This way actually, what is the procedure of preaching Mahaprabhu going to teach us? If you are at all Gaudiya devotee, you should follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the great and unique teacher on this infinity Brahmanda. Prabhupada speaking. That's why we know already in Ashtakam Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there you know, he is going to teach the whole world, teacher. And actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to express humble attitude. That's why they are bound to come and catch his hand. Please come and sit with us. Then he was bound to sit and expressing some light from the body, impersonal Brahma effulgent, some effulgent, not impersonal. Brahma is there, itself present there, Mahaprabhu there. That time, that those, you know, Mayabadi, they ask him, actually you are doing Sankirtan. You are always doing Sankirtan. We know. But what the, why you are not coming to us to hear Vedanta? What's wrong in it? You are always doing Sankirtan, Nam Sankirtan. But one question we have, why you are not going to, why you are not going to come in front of us? Why? To hear Vedanta? What's wrong in it? Then Mahaprabhu, with very humble attitude speaking, actually I have no capacity, I have no qualification to hear Vedanta. That's why I am not coming. Because my Gurudev told, you are foolish number one, you have no right in Vedanta, better you can go on doing Sankirtan. Guru more murkho dekhi karilo sasan, that tumi murkho tomar Vedanta nahi adhikar, you have no right in Vedanta, Vedanta you said, you know, erudite scholar, they can go through Vedanta. You are foolish, so you should not go through Vedanta, you can go on chanting. By the order of Gurudev, I am doing Sankirtan all the time. So, I am doing Sankirtan, what to do? And I am dancing and singing out of my, you know, some ecstatic feeling. One day I was bound to put one question in front of Gurudev. Oh Gurudev, what is the magic result of this Harinam? I am doing, I am going to follow your order, but this name making me mad and crazy. I am dancing, singing. How? What is the magic spell? Guru told, this is the ultimate result of Sankirtan. You are very successful. This is the actual result of ultimate goal of Sankirtan. That you are getting. Through Sankirtan you are getting ecstatic prema, lava. You are singing and dancing. You are not going to think what people can speak. I am mad. I am dancing like crazy. Let them speak. Like Pallad Maharaj, what doing? Rauti, rauti, rudati, lokobaiya. He is actually singing and dancing, crying, Prahlad Maharaj, not going to think that some people can think that I am crazy. Let them think. Nittati lokobaiya. Rudati, rauti, hasati, rudati, rauti. Lokobaiya. Who is speaking what? Who is going to pass any what remark? I am less interested about. You have no information. If you are going to get lava, prema, then you can have no information. But who is going to criticize you, what? So this way actually, Prabhupada was speaking, that Mahaprabhu going to show them the humble attitude. Ultimately, Mahaprabhu wanted to prove that this Mayabad Bichar is totally wrong. Mayabad Bichar is totally wrong. Not only that, out of his humble attitude and, you know, full submission, Mahaprabhu speaking this way, so all those Mayavadi, they are bound to change their decision. All this, you know, 10,000 at least, you know, Mayavadis, they are going to change their heart. They are going to change their heart. They are also dancing and singing in a temple, Bindu Madhav Mandir, in Varanasi. They are also now dancing. What is the magic spell? So you can remember, those Saujiyas can identify that we are following Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we are doing bhajan of But actually, Boba speaking, they are not at all doing. They are not actually following Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They are totally deviated from the track of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The only procedure through which you can detect, if you can find that this, you know, preacher going to follow that intact procedure of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, everything, then you should remember it's perfect preaching. Otherwise, preaching is not perfect. And ultimately going to give such a toxic result, poisonous result, you will have to suffer like cancerous disease. With cancerous disease, inside developing cancerous disease, outside so many ornament and nice clothes you are, but inside cancerous disease going to spoil the whole program. You cannot stop it, but it's a must. What to do? These procedures shown by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu are successful. We, Gaudiyas, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, are going to follow this procedure. Also, Prabhupada speaking something which is very, very important, that yesterday also I was speaking, Rupa Goswami Pad expressing so humble attitude, not to speak. Hidi yasya peraneya pavartito aham barak rupopi. Hidi yasya peraneya pavartito aham barak rupopi. Tasso charana kamalam vande si chaitanya devasya. Hridi yasya peraneya, by the inspiration, by the inspiration of that Supreme Lord, whose inspiration, by whose inspiration, I am taking so much endeavor to take up this great job of Rasamrita Sindhu. Oh my God! How dare! By the Hidi Yasya Peranaya, by the inspiration of that Supreme Lord, by whose inspiration, I am bound to take up this great job to compile this Rasamrita Sindhu. Hridi yasya peraneya pavartito aham barak rupopi. I am a crane. Crane mean crane bird. Crane, you know, having long neck and beak. Beak, you know. Yesterday I was speaking, and long leg. Very slowly going. They want to prove they were very dharmic, pious. But they are actually going to ruin the whole program. They are going to kill. They are going to kill. Actually, this vulture is going to take some dead body. But that crane, that bird, going to take living elements from water. Tack! Gone. Tack! Swallow! Oh my God! Living! Oh, Ram, you are speaking his mercy? He is a very big sadhu. Yesterday I was explaining. So you see the humble mood of Guru Bhargava Sanatan Rupa Goswami. We want to maintain that hereditary factor. We want to maintain that hereditary factor. We don't want to learn a new theory. We want to follow Sanatan Rupa, Jiva Goswami path, that procedure. You can remember I told at the Abhirbhav, Jiva Goswami Pada's appearance there, when Balava Acharya is going to speak in front of Rupa Goswami Pada, what book you are assuming? I can rectify the book. After compilation, you can give to me. So much popped up. Speaking this way, he gone to take bath in Jamuna, and Jiva Goswami Pada is taking permission from Gurudev, oh Gurudev, Rupa Goswami Pada. There is water, I need to bring water from Jamuna. Okay, you can go. Then, Jiva Goswami Pad going and chasing that man who is expressing this kind of vanity to edit the book of my Gurudev, Paramahansa Sesha Rupa Goswami Pad. Then asking, excuse me, if you never mind, what kind of mistake you have seen in the books, of my Gurudev so that you spoke that way? Who you are? Actually, that boy you saw there, na? Is my Gurudev. What kind of mistake you find there so that you wanted to rectify that book? Then one by one he started giving argument, and Jiva Goswami was also going to give argument. Within a few minutes, he discovered, I am foolish in front of this small boy. Who so great Pandit in the world? In the world, Jiva Goswami was the topmost Pandit. No father going to take birth to defeat Jiva Goswami. He was very shocked to see. After that, he was bound to change his mood. If you say Jiva Goswami was speaking this way, it is not humble attitude. I say, no, it is 100% humble attitude. You don't know. What do you mean by humble attitude? You mean humble attitude? One chakalpadar vasyakibhasana. Humble attitude externally and inside duplicity. You think this is humbleness? No. To rectify the prestige of Guru Varga, to rectify the distorted prestiges by somebody, to rectify it and re-announce in front of a public, this is not correct, this is correct. He's going to insult my Guru Varga. This is called humbleness. To insult Guru Varga is not humbleness. To insult Guru Varga is not humbleness. Jiva Goswami was saying, this is humbleness. This can prove the 100% perfect servitorship. This can prove the attitude of Jiva Goswami Path can prove 100% perfect servitorship unto the lotus feet of his Gurudev. This is the. You will have to rectify this way. Otherwise, you are not from Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math. You are outside, fallen soul. You have to prove that way. Now, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada speaking in front of Guru Varga. Oh, my friends, oh, my Shiksha Guru Varga, I like to remind you two sloka written by our Prabhu Rupa Goswami Pad in Rasamrita Sindhu. You should not forget, he is speaking this way. I want to give you a reminder, fresh reminder. You should not forget all the every fraction of second you will have to remember. For a fraction of second you are going to forget this thing, you will have to get deviated from the track of Guru Varga. Be careful. This is my request. What that two sloka? Is the topmost secrecy of Gaudiya Bhajan, written by Rupa Goswami Pad. Anasaktasya visayana yatharahum upayanyata upayanyata nirvandha krishna sambandhi yuktam vairagyam uchyate. Another sloka spoken by Rupa Goswami Pad, what? Prapanchikataya vidhya hari sambandhi vastina mumukshovir munusta mumuktavir parityago vairagyam phalgu kathate. Follow. Yukto vairagyo, by these two sloka, Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math like to teach you the exact balanced way. Fine demarcation, finest demarcation is there. Finest demarcation there between yukto vairagya and bhoga. Bhoga and tyaga. Two procedure you so long from your birth, you are going to follow this procedure. Either bhoga, enjoyment, or renouncement, tyaga. But you never heard this question of balanced vairagya. What do you mean by yukta vairagya? Yes, this is a key to your success in your bhajan. It's the key of success. If you cannot open the key of the treasure in the room, there is big treasure, you cannot open the key, then how you can get entry to get all the treasure there in Gaudiya Mission? You cannot. That's why Prabhupada told, to enter into Gaudiya Math, the gateway is very small. Really so. I can explain this point tomorrow. Be careful to get entry into Gaudiya Mission and Gaudiya Math. The gateway is so narrow, so many check-up is there, security force, that they can check you out and throw outside. Go! You are not allowed in Gaudiya Math. Follow? I can explain this point tomorrow. What kind of security you witness in airport? What kind of security you find in parliament? What kind of security? More and more topmost security there in Gaudiya Mission. You have no entry inside Gaudiya Mission if you are not at all going to develop that kind of mood shown by Rupa Goswami Pada. I can prove tomorrow. What is the advice of Prabhupada? One new historical world can open. If I go on speaking infinity pure about Prabhupada, be careful. Don't try to insult. Try to understand the mood of Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. What is the secrecy there? All the immense treasure there shown by Rupa Goswami Pada, all inside Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math. I am bound to see it. I am in Vyasasana, I promise. Yes, property there. You can point out those idiots, they are doing some fighting there. I said they are out of Gaudiya Math. They are not in Gaudiya Math. Who told they are in Gaudiya Math? Who told? They are in Gaudiya Math, you are going to specify. They are fighting in Gaudiya Math. In Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math, there is no fighting. You are foolish. Your darshan is very dirty, so you are fighting. They have no entry into Gaudiya Mission. Gaudiya Math. That's why they find this kind of fighting. They have no entry. Even if I get a one chance to stay inside Gaudiya Math for one night only, that is more than sufficient. Because to stay in Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math means to stay in Dibbat Bindaranya Kalpadrumada Srimada Taga Singha Sanastho Shishi Radha Silagavinda Dibbau Peshali Visebh Manusva. I am in Kalpadrumadha, that Kalpa Bhiksha, where the exceptional service, unique service of Radha Govinda going on all the time by Gopikas and Guru Varga. That is called Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math. All the time non-stop seva going on. You find external appliances in Gaudiya Math, but that appliance not going to touch my heart a little bit. No smell of dirty attitude going to touch my heart. Let there be opulences in Gaudiya Math. That is one kind of yukta vairagya. One kind of yukta vairagya, balanced vairagya. You will have to understand this balanced vairagya under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Because Rupa Goswami was speaking, anasakta savisayana yatharham upayanjata nirvanda krishna sambandhi yuktam Vairagya Muchyate. I am not going to accept any black money from you, but surely I am going to accept Madhukuri from you. If you say, Maharaj, somehow I arrange this amount of money, you please, then I am bound to accept. And be sure I am not going to misuse that money. I am not going to open one bank balance to, you know, to take all money myself. To enjoy, not. Whatever amount coming Madhukuri Viksha, I am going to utilize this for the actual purpose of Chaitanya Vani, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Seva, or related Seva, devotee Seva, Gomata Seva, all related Tadiyavasu Seva. You can remember Sridhar, Kholabacha Sridhar, who used to sell the inside part of banana trees. Kholabacha Sridhar there used to sell very poor, and going to take one third for the service of Ganga Ji, and one part for Ganga Ji, another for family maintenance, one for sadhu, for internal seva inside, this way four part. So humble, so humble. This way, Diskinchan, Prabhupada, only Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, wanted to teach us the way of yukta vairagya, balanced vairagya. You will have to take shelter of that fine demarcation mark. So accurate fine demarcation, if you little bit, 0.0000001% coming left side, you are bogie. You are bogie. And little bit, 0.00 this person, you are taggy. But you are going to, you will have to maintain a fine balance on this point. But unluckily, nobody can maintain this fine balance. Somehow, if whole world going to worship me, then my heart become puffed up. I am all in all. Who is Guru Varga? Throw them outside. Oh, I am all in all. Bas. That is called demonic character. That is called demonic character. This way preaching can never be done. Totally wrong procedure pursued by you. Totally wrong procedure. The procedure shown by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Prabhupada used to sit very smartly, go very smartly in front of, you know, big Lord Karjan, this, that, big personality from British country. They are Prabhupada swaying with turban, this, that. Who are you in front of me? Foolish number one. But Prabhupada never wanted to insult them. Prabhupada knowing very good. What is the formula, Prabhupada speaking? Maybe they have less idea about spiritual world. But materially, they are climbing the topmost platform. We are backward. Oh, my friend, you should go and open your heart of humbleness and actual scientific procedure of preaching. I am sure they know to respect. They know how to respect other. Not like that in the society at present. If they find a nice Maharaj, cut him, beat him, throw him out, ignore him. That is the degradation of humanity. Prabhupada showing us, if I find that this society going to ignore and insult Guru Vaishnava, 100% the society going to be destroyed. The society in which nobody going to honor woman resource, Matajis, the society in which nobody going to give honor to Matajis, that society is corrupted society. 100% material prosperity can come, they are going to come down. Only in India, in this Sanatana Shastra, we are going to treat them, Mataji, you are my mother, you are my daughter. This philosophy, not possible there outside. Even they are taking sannyas, not possible. They can touch salgam and speak. You are speaking, seeing this way, not possible. Only. So, the society where we are not going to give honor to any pandit, exalted person, we are going to insult him out of jealousy. The society we are not going to use the human resource properly. The society we are going to ignore the, you know, children's of his country, future generation, that society bound to be finished. 100%. You will have to understand this point. That is why Prabhupada used to give honor to different devotees. His disciple. But Prabhupada never said, he is not my disciple, all my Guru Varga. So he should get this title. He should get this title. At present, who is going to give title to whom? If anybody going to hear Harikatha, don't go there. Don't go and hear Harikatha. Because you can change your heart, then we cannot cheat you. We cannot cheat you anymore. Our market can get lost. We are actually medicine canvasser. You know, those who are medicine canvasser, they are going different field. If they find another canvasser, hey, why you are coming in my field? This is my field. Why you are coming? Are a sadhu is open. For a sadhu, the whole world is open market. Anybody can hear Harikatha to change their heart and character. You are going to stop them hearing. That means you are following envious attitude. Your envious attitude can kill you. Your envious attitude can kill you itself. It cannot come out successful. So, you will have to understand the fine balance of Yukta Vairagya. What is the point of Yukta Vairagya? totally neutral position. I am going to serve Supreme Lord. I am not going to play my head over my enjoyment and renouncement. Enjoyment and renouncement, both we should throw out. If I need to go to European society to sit in their society and speak very smartly with costly clothes, I think it is Yukta Vairagya. It cannot touch me. You can identify me when I am alone with copin and dirty clothes. This is my Yukta Vairagya I have to learn. Follow? You have to learn Yukta Vairagya. Prabhupada speaking, I can come down to any level for the actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani. Even some of his so-called disciples could not understand the mood of Prabhupada. They misunderstand Prabhupada. They leave Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. So it's a Yukta Vairagya. If there is no affinity, if there is no attraction, so why you are going to reject? I cannot see the face of any Mataji. Why? You are big brahmachari. You are big sannyasi. You want to prove? Mataji, what problem they have done? You have some weakness inside your weak point. That's why you like to reject them, throw them out. Why? I must speak in front of Mataji. But alone I cannot allow. Anywhere I am going to Jalandhar here, there, my first declaration that within 10 to 10:30, any outside people allowed inside my room, and baby Mataji is coming, but Matajis are not allowed alone. They can take their brother, mother, or their relative, son, husband, or any temple member they can bring. Otherwise, they cannot open temple. If they can come together, I can give answer. They can sit 1 hour. But after that, I can close my door. I have to light so many things I have seva. This is my procedure, I openly declare. Maharaj, you will have to go to our house. No! I cannot go to anybody's house. This is the house. It's Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's temple. This is your house. You will have to come here. I cannot go to anybody's house. You will have to come here. Here, Harikatha, or you can go away. My strict declaration. First declaration. Never ask any money from me, but forcefully, Maharaj, you will have to take. Okay. I take it and use for seva. Yukta Vairagya. You are in front of outside people. Outsider coming to take prasadam. I heard from Prabhupada, indirectly through speech written, I heard from Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. I heard from Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami, you can go mad. Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami, penniless Vaishnav that time. But when somehow Mott was there, someday Guru Maharaj speaking, today you should arrange nice prasadam because outside people come. Some devotee experience doubt. Gurudev speaking this way? What is this? Very bad? Palatable prasad? What is this? Gurudev should not speak that way. Bas, they fall down. They don't understand. Madhav Goswami Maharaj, in Mayapur, one day watching some young group coming to see Dhamma, then they say, Madhav Goswami Maharaj. They say, Madhav, that is a unique success of Madhav Goswami Maharaj. With humble mood. Baba, my son, where from you all coming? Maharaj, we are coming from this place. Okay, you have taken prasadam? No. You can take prasadam here. Today, we can arrange prasadam. Actually, we have no money to pay for prasadam. What to speak about money? I speak money? You have to take prasadam. Then going to kitchen and asking, you will have to make some brinjal fry, nice dal, chana rasa. Why? Because first of all, you have to catch their mood. And ultimately, if you are going to engage them in Hari Bhajan, first you will have to show your humble attitude, humble mood, trinadapi, and seva mood. That is a unique procedure through which you can get victory over somebody. If at all that somebody love me, you ask them why they love me. I have no property, nothing. Why they love me? For this reason. Maybe limited people. I cannot expect thousands of people to follow me. They cannot digest. They can develop loose emotion and go to latrine. They cannot digest Harikatha. So, this way actually, you'll have to understand this point. So, Prabhupada is going to teach us this Yukta Vairagya. Only and only Gaudiya Mission can show you this procedure. Prabhupada inviting big personalities from outside. They spiritually near not big. Maybe one scientist, one big officer. What is the procedure? And Prabhupada speaking that you should give honor to everybody. Maybe they are material. Prabhupada teaching us. Prabhupada teaching us. You should give honor to each and every person. Maybe they are spiritually not elevated, but they have some material qualities. Maybe he is triple MA. I am not triple MA. You should give honor to them. It also can bring success in your life. You have to give their, you know, their due respect. I must give respect to this Mataji. I must give respect to this man, everybody. I must give respect. I am not going to insult them. But if at all, somebody is going to accept me 100% from heart, in that case, to rectify you, I can beat you in front of public. Public can say, Maharaj is merciless beating. I can beat. And that can prove my humbleness. That can prove my mercy. You see? Because repeatedly I am speaking, you are not going to follow. Vrindavan Das is speaking. Eto porihare je papi lajja je papi ninda kore. Eto porihare je papi ninda kore. Tobe lathi maruta sirer upore. Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya. After so much argument given by me, if somebody giving again going to express some doubt about Nityananda and this, that, then I am going to last final medicine, I am going to kick on their head. To change their head. But public cannot understand. That is the humble mood. That is Yukta Vairagya shown by Vrindavan Das Thakur. That is called Yukta Vairagya, humble mood. That is called Jiva Daya. He wants to kick on them to give dust particle from his lotus feet to change their mood and to give inspiration so that they can, you know, get inspiration to do Hari Bhajan. Naishang mati stavat uruk karmangin spreshati. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Now speaking Prahlad Maharaj? Speaking now, many times I told people. Naishang mati stavat uruk karmangin prishyata narthap gamo yadartho mahiya sampad raja avishekam niskinchananam na brinito yavad. So long you are not going to take dust particle from the lotus feet of a Paramahansa Guru, you are not going to develop humble attitude. Never. Maybe you have so many qualities. What it concerns to me? But that qualities cannot be used in Ikshat Krishna Seva. Maybe I know you have property, but that property cannot be used in Krishna Seva. That was the judgment of Prabhupada. Prabhupada speaking, if I cannot do something good for you, I cannot take anything from you. Prabhupada speaking, very secrecy. If you are not going to accept anything from me, I am also not going to accept anything from you. Be careful. If you are going to accept something from me, then I can accept, because it can prove the sloka by Rupa Goswami. Dadati pratiginyati prichati guhyama khati bhungte bhayate sarvida pratilakshanam. You are not going to get my association. Then I am not going to get association, your association. There is a secrecy of preaching. Follow? That's why Madhu Goswami used to go door to door to take Madhukuri. That's why it is the procedure, Prabhupada speaking, we will have to take, accept Madhukuri Bhiksha from everybody to render our daily service there in Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math. And that can automatically bring some good for those bonded soul, automatically. Because we are not going to cheat their money. This way we will have to apply this rule of preaching without knowing, without knowing, without hearing Harikatha from Guru Varga properly, you are going for preaching. It is one kind of accident you are meeting in your life. It can destroy your whole society and you yourself, or together with all your followers. You have to follow the procedure of Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. Otherwise, big problem. That day I was speaking, maybe 7-10 days ago, this material world is Kuntamay Jagat. And that world is Vaikuntha Jagat. That was it, Vaikuntha Jagat. There is no hesitation, no enmity, no partiality, no envious attitude, nothing there. Where? In the transcendental world. And here, naturally, Dham is there. With Dham also you are developing this kind of facility, this kind of advantage to grow your angry attitude, this, that, because your darshan is not perfect. The speciality is that if I reach that Vaikuntha, there is no contamination, pure. And here, when Dham coming here, there you can see Dham, though your eyes is not matured to see Dham, but still, together with them you can find some hotel going on, these, that material point. There is a mixing, magic spell of Maya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Maya Devi going to cover up this Dhamma, Maya Devi going to make one network on this Dhamma. Say, actually you cannot touch Dhamma. Actually you cannot see Dhamma. You can spend 80 lakhs, 80,000 rupees or for going also, maybe 4 lakhs you are wasting money. Follow, I know. But how you can touch Dham, how you can see Dham, how you can see Guru Vaishnava, that is the main issue. That is the issue. In what condition, in what level you have to go up so that you can clearly see this is Dhamma. You can see Guru Vaishnava properly. What level you have to go up? You have to understand this point. So in this material world is one kind of jugglery by Maya. I can go to Vrindavan. Hey, there is so much monkeys taking my speck. Okay. And those, you know, boar, they speak, they are passing stool and urine. Yeah. Oh. Drainage system is very bad. Drainage system, you know, very bad. This is Vrindavan Darshan. This is Vrindavan Darshan. But Guru Varga can see Vrindavan from here more clearly than you. You can take trouble to go to Puri and, you know, fight with public to see, take darshan of Jagannath. But Guru Varga from here can see Jagannath more clearly than you. That is the difference between you and Guru Varga. So clear darshan, they can see. They need not go to Vrindavan. Sarup Gosai not going to Vrindavan in his whole life. Sarup Gosai never going to Vrindavan in whole life. Prabhudananda Saraswati were never going, coming to Navadvip Dham. But that Prabhudananda Saraswati is writing about Navadvip Satakam. And he is writing some glories about Vrindavan Satakam. Oh my gosh. How possible? He never been there in the, who told? They are eternally present in Vrindavan. They are eternally present in Vrindavan. Who told they have not seen Vrindavan? Who told you? They are present in Vrindavan. Vrindavan is not a place by your manpower you can make a big building and express. And all flying with lakhs of dollars. All flying. After Gurudev gone, they are flying. They collect money up to Gurudev leaving. They want to prove their submission, humbleness. After that, they are taking a maid. Somebody flying with 2 crore rupees, somebody 5 crore, somebody 1 crore, they are flying. This is called Rupanuga Bhajan. Follow. This is called Yukta Vairagya, which can make you a cheater, which can make you a thief, which can make you a dacoit, hooligan. This is the procedure you will have to. So proper procedure you should understand and go ahead. Maybe whole world can go against me because I am speaking this way, but I am speaking about the absolute truth. Nothing to do. So yukto vairagya, I have to maintain. Why? Those gopikas, they are putting on ornament. Very nice, decorated hair, very nice cloth. Those gopikas, they are having yukto vairagya. Only they are thinking how to satisfy Supreme Lord from heart. That is a yukto vairagya. They can put on ornaments, but you have no right to take one, you know, ring in hand. But they have their right. They can take whole nice ornament, everything, and nice, nice clothes, everything, decorate their body for the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord Krishna. But you are going to satisfy your sense organ. You are not going to follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You are not going to follow Prabhupada. So you see that your yukta vairagya son by Prabhupada, Jyakta Vairagya Sanvai, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. When first Mercedes car was there in Gaudiya Mission, then everybody started criticizing Prabhupada. Hey, sadhu, he is going to, get into car? He is going to. Then Prabhupada speaking, yes, when I am acting as Acharya, when going to exhibit the procedure of yukta vairagya, it is quite natural. I will have to get into a car. Very nice. I can go by car. People can come into temple. I can write no admission. Why? Well, people can think that we are very cheap sadhu. So they can come, we can write no admission without permission. Prabhupada singing, we have to write this. At the same time, we'll have to break their false ego and do kippa on them. When they can open their eyes, they can see me. Why Prabhupada not going to put some restriction for Ramananda Prabhu, Sridhar Maharaj? When Sridhar Maharaj came in Gaudiya Mission, then my Guru Maharaj was there that time. He was Brahmachari that time. And Sridhar Mahaprabhu with pant and coat, everything, speaking English very nice. You know, very nice legal advisor. Then they went to ask permission from Guru Maharaj, from Prabhupada. Prabhupada is coming, we can allow you? Prabhupada, yes, you can allow him. Because Prabhupada knows the heart. He is my eternal parshad. So, what is the ultimate outcome? How we can know he is the disciple of Prabhupada, he is the actual follower of Prabhupada? The only procedure is that when you find the same Siddhanta, Acharan, etiquette, everything flowing through Gaura Parampara, same, then you can say surely. If you find some distortion, some bent, not eternal process of Prabhupada. He's going to make some new world. Now, yesterday you can remember, I was speaking about the secrecy of Panchatattva. Panchatattmatakam Krishnam Bhaktarupa Sarupam Sarupakam. This Panchatattva is one and the same. Gorangapu coming in five different forms. At the Zibdaib, all five and all fours are there in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu itself. Bande Guruno, Isho Bhaktanu, Isho Mishavatar Khan. This sloka you will have to understand. Then you can understand how different way Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave. Then you cannot feel any inspiration to insult Guru Varga. If you understand this theory, Bande Guruno, Isho Bhaktanu, Isho Mishavatar Khan. This sloka if you understand, this sloka you will have to remember. That Supreme Lord Himself coming in five different forms. Bande Guruno, all my Guru Varga. Try to understand, I am not manufacturing a philosophy. I am not manufacturing a philosophy, I am speaking intact way, what I got from Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing commentary. All Guru Varga coming, Sadguru, those who are following Prabhupada, they all should be honored. Bande Guru Uno. Without paying honor to Guru Varga, even I have no right to pay to Supreme Lord. Someday somebody paying Nitha, paying Gauranga Mahaprabhu first, not paying Dandavata Nityananda Prabhu. Hey! You have done mistake! You can go through Vrindavan Dasa Guru, you know, Chaitanya Bhagavat. Somebody coming and paying Dandavata Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Hey! You have done mistake! Go on, pay Dandavata Nityananda. Foolish. You don't know. In front of Prabhupada, some devotee, he was bound to pay Dandavat to Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj. Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj, about whom I was speaking. The age of Bhakti Vivek Bharati was a little bit higher than Prabhupada that time. But age factor is not so important. He is Guru. In front of Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj, some foolish devotee coming and paying Sastanga Dandavat to Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj. And Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj became very angry and speaking was slag language to him. Then Prabhupada looking at Bhakti Vivek, why you are speaking this slag language? Why you are speaking this slag language? You should not. He was very angry because in front of Prabhupada is being Dandavat to. This is the mood of Guru Varga. So first of all, Bande Guruno. Isho Bhaktyano. Isho, but Bhaktyano. Isho Bhaktyano mean? Who? Sivas Pandit. Isho Bhakta. Supreme Lord coming in the form of Isho Bhakta. Isho Bhaktyano. Bande Guruno, Isho Bhaktyano. Isho Mishabhat. Isho Avatar. Advaita Gosai. Isho Prakash. Tat Prakashansa, Tat Taktings. And this. So, Nityananda Bhu Tat Prakash. And Tat Shakti, Gadadhar Pandit. This way, in five different forms, we can get the Tattva of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We have no scope to insult anybody. We have to pay more and more respect to Guru Varga. More and more respect to Guru Varga. Otherwise, we cannot do Krishna Bhajan. Shaksha Dharityana Samasya Sastri, okay. After that speaking, actually Krishna Bhagavan speaking in front of Uddhava Ji Maharaj. Uddhava, Guru Tattva is so excellent. You will have to approach Guru Tattva in very humble way. Because Guru Tattva can give me. Only Guru can give me. Directly you cannot come to me. Tadvidhi panipadhyana padivyasana sevaya upadikshanti de jnanam jnaninas tattva darshina. Tadvijnanartham sa guru mevhavi gachet. Tadvijnanartham sa guru mevhavi gachet. Samitapani sautiyam brahmanishtam. You will have to approach that kind of Guru. Many times I told Guru Tattva, very secret Tattva. You have to understand how to honor Guru. Even material people, there some teacher coming here. I honor him. I say apni. I give respect to him. He only maybe 28 years of age. But still I am giving honor. But when I find somebody going to insult Guru Varga, then I cannot give honor to him. I can give fitting answer to him. This is my Siddhanta. This is that I getting this lesson from Prabhupada. To become excited in the insultment of Guru Varga is called Vaishnava. Vaishnavata. We will have to learn it from Sridhar Goswami Maharaj what is Yukta Vairagya. Day by day I can go on explaining this point. You can understand, oh, so nice fine secrecy there in bhajan. If we cannot follow, we cannot do bhajan. We cannot do. If you run here and there, I cannot take any responsibility. If you are going to follow Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, then I am bound to take your responsibility. Otherwise not. Different kind of teachings going on, different kind of wrong Siddhanta, infighting is not expected. Infighting is not good. Why I can make wrong Siddhanta? Whereas about this point already our Guru Bhargava told. There is any scope to make one new Siddhanta? Hari? All Guru Bhargava already told Siddhanta. You have to follow. Making mistake. So all thousands of people can go to hell. What to do? I told you, na? Jo bhakti nairahitam. Jo bhakti who is speaking wrong Siddhanta. Yo bhakti nairahitam annayena srinatiya. To ubho. To ubho. Brijataha nirayam kalam akshayam. Who is going to speak wrongly? We are all going to hear wrongly. Both of them can go to hell for infinity period. They cannot get respite. Better I have no guru. Okay. Better I have no guru. Okay. Someday I can get guru. For that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, you should not run here and there. Guru bho 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 shantis shishya vitta paharakaha sadguru durlabo devi shishya santa paharakaha. Shankar Bhagavan, the great Acharya, speaking to Devi, Mahadevi, Parvati. Devi, there can be, you can find so many guru, countless guru. They are going to take away all money, position and respect from the society of disciples. They cannot give any good to anybody. Guru bho bahuva santi, there are so many countless gurus, Devi. But they are going to take away money, position, respect, everything. They cannot arrange absolute good for you. Mahadev Shankar Bhagavan speaking. Durlabha Gurur Devi, Sishya Santapaharakaha. Santap, all the burning position of disciple. He is crying, O Gurudev, save me. Yes! Only Paramahansa Sadguru can save him. He can take like blotting paper, you know? Don't know? Previously, when I was child, that time father or they give to give blotting paper. I started writing with fountain pen. Sometime ink coming, you know, more ink. That time the writings become destroyed. Then we put the one piece of paper is there, it's called blotting paper. If you put, then automatically that extra water or, you know, can go. This is called blotting paper. This way, previously we were, at present not. So this way, as soon as you reach a Sadguru who is big, powerful, you can take away all your dirty things, all sinful activities you have done for infinity period, can take within fraction of second. And make you free from sinful activities. It is the Siddhanta Prabhupada. A Sadguru never going to give Diksha to anybody, keeping intact his previous condition. Follow? Follow what I mean to say? A Sadguru never going to give initiation to anybody, keeping intact his previous condition. His previous dirtiness is there, but still he is saying, I am initiated. How possible? Only Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada can speak. Nobody can speak. They can pass away this point. Prabhupada speaking. Sadguru never going to give initiation, keeping intact his previous dirty condition. First condition of Diksha, he can take away all dirty things from your heart. Make you pure up to now. Up to now, what you have done in your life, mentally, physically, somehow, for infinity pure, all vanish. That is the procedure of Diksha. What is the procedure of Diksha? Dibya Gyan Yato Dadyat Kuryat Papasya Sanshayam. That is the main procedure of Diksha, through which you are going to lose all your dirty heart, you are going to lose all your sinful activities, all clean up to now, and you are going to develop Dibya Gyan, transcendental knowledge. If at all not there, what kind of Diksha you have done? Maharaj, I have taken Diksha 40 years over. From where you have taken Diksha? 40 years over. And now he is going to pass remark. 40 years over, taken Diksha, and going to pass remark. Maharaj, my life is just spoiled. But even spoiled, he cannot speak. He is speaking, my life is spoiled. He cannot speak spoiled. You see the mood. He is staying in Gaudiya Math for 40 years. He is spoiling Sadhguru. He is speaking in front of me. In front of me, one of the disciples of Bhakti, you know, Bhakti Vita Madhava Goswami Maharaj. He is speaking, my life is spoiled, Maharaj. He cannot pronounce spoiled. He says, my life is spoiled. That kind of educated people now in coming in Gaudiya society. They can take Chanarasa, Puspanna, Paramanna, nice sweet ball. And fight with each other. Hey, you are. Eh? This is the condition. Who are totally, you know, going to, you know, dishonor Prabhupada. That's why this condition. Why this condition we are fighting? We are not going to follow Prabhupada. We are not at all following Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. If at all we are following, this kind of condition can never arise. Not possible. So this way, we'll have to understand Yukta Vairagya, and tomorrow I can speak so many things because day is approaching, Gaur Purnima, I'll have to seek all secret Siddhanta regarding Gaur Avatar, this, that. Excuse me. So, the sloka I started with, you can remember what sloka you should remember. Kalo Narajan Jagatam Param Gurum Tilokonathanatapadpankajam prayenamartha bhagavantamachyutam jakshantipasannabibhinnachetasa vanchakalpatarvasikvasa.